Hi guys, I thought what we'd do today is look at 10 things that can make a difference to your photography right now. The first thing is the camera gear. Get the camera gear and move on. At the end of the day, it's probably less important than you would imagine. Really, you know, if you've got a 30,000 Rand camera or a 100,000 Rand camera or a 10,000 Rand camera, it's pretty much of a muchness. Sure, the 100,000 Rand camera will have better ISO performance and better autofocus performance and, but it's not going to create you better, more evocative, more creative images. That's up to you. Lenses, though, perhaps a little bit of a different story. Do get the very, very best lenses you can, because at the end of the day, you're going to be upgrading the body. You know that's going to happen already. And what you don't want to do is have to upgrade your lenses. You want to get lenses that offer you good, sharp, good contrast, good color, and then you can buy them and you've got them for a long, long time. Number two. Use your camera every day. Well, maybe not every day, but certainly use it often. Even if it's just to take it out of the cupboard, take it out of the camera bag and fiddle with it, shoot a couple of random pictures, get to know the controls, get to know the feel of it so that it becomes transparent in your hands, so that you can use it without thinking about where the controls are and what's happening. You know, when things are going down in the bush, You can't be wondering where the ISO adjustment button is or where the exposure compensation button is. You must know that. That must just happen instinctively so that you're not thinking about what you're doing with the camera, but rather thinking about how that image is coming together. What is the composition looking like? What is the exposure doing? All those critical things that go up to making a really, really good image. You don't need to be thinking about the controls and where they are and what I should do now. You need to use that camera as often as you can to get that muscle memory going properly. Number three, check the camera settings when you go out. We've just done a little video called Miffed, and it's about how to prevent being miffed that you've got your settings wrong. Do check it out by clicking the little link on the top right hand corner of the screen. But check your camera before you go out on a shoot. What you don't want to do is have your settings from the previous shoot still in the camera and you're going out shooting something completely different and you end up not getting your image. And sometimes those first images, particularly if you're shooting wildlife, are absolutely critical. You get to the sighting, you get some pictures, and it's quite often those first pictures that are going to be about the best. Number four, study pictures. Look at pictures. Look at them on Instagram. Look at them on Facebook, look at them in books and magazines and calendars and everywhere you can see photographs. Look at them and study them, reverse engineer them, try and figure out what the photographer did to get those pictures. Don't copy what he did, learn from what he did or she and implement those ideas, those thoughts, those creative processes into your photography. I look at dozens and dozens of pictures on a daily basis. It's what I do. It's how I get ideas, it's how I get thoughts, and then I take my response to those images and then utilize that in my own creative process when I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to shoot a particular subject. Number five, learn. Learn as much as you can. Now, the first way to learn is to search YouTube, amongst other places, for free photographic tutorials, and there are thousands of them out there, including ours. And you might like to just check our channel and our playlist for Learn Photography. We've got a whole bunch of tutorials up already and more and more coming. But find those tutorials, find that information. There's just boatloads of the stuff out there, and learn from those comments, learn from those photographers about how they look at photography and how they interpret scenes and subjects and that sort of thing. And then take what you like out of that and apply it to your photography. Number six, edit your pictures. Edit them for two things. One, get rid of the junk. There's no point in keeping rubbish. And, you know, you don't want people to see your failures. So get rid of those for a start. Then your keepers, work on them. You know, with film in the old days when we started shooting, when you hit the shutter button on the camera, it was pretty much the end of your involvement. These days, it doesn't work like that. These days, when you hit the shutter button on the camera, it's pretty much the beginning of your involvement. And so all our images go into mainly Adobe Lightroom, and they get checked for sharpness, they get checked for color balance, for a multitude of things. We don't do much in the way of moving pixels. In other words, we don't put stuff into pictures or take stuff out of pictures. But we do check the contrast, we do check the saturation levels and enhance those images to get them looking as good as we possibly can get them. We shoot raw images as opposed to JPEGs, and we've covered raw in a previous video, so you might like to check that out. But with raw, we're using the data that the camera has saved without any in-camera processing, and we apply that processing, and you get much more control over it rather than shooting JPEGs where that profile is baked into the image. So do give that one a go. There are many, many programs out there. Lightroom is our favorite, Adobe Lightroom, but there are any number of image editors out there, some free, some not so free. Number seven, keep the camera steady. Make sure that it's locked down. When you're in the bush and you've got a long lens on that camera, it is so easy to get camera shake coming into the camera. So either use a tripod or one of the fancy camera mounts that you can get for your vehicle, or just a simple beanbag. And that's one of my favorite, is you just put a beanbag down. We make a nice big chunky beanbag. You can put it on the windowsill of the vehicle or in a roll bar or wherever it is. Put the camera on there and you've got the camera locked down. And so you're not getting camera shake, or at least you are minimizing your camera shake. Look, you're still going to have to deal with animal movement and you're still going to have to keep shutter speeds in mind. But you know, when you're holding up a 400mm lens or a 600mm lens, it can get quite heavy and you start to move. But anyway, just keep the camera locked down so that there is absolutely no camera movement. Number eight, move your camera. Depending on what you're doing, it doesn't always make sense to have the camera locked down solid. What you don't want is to have little jittery shakes coming through, but try and move your camera. Set up a slow shutter speed onto your camera and move it. Follow that herd of zebras as they gallop across the plains. Do a slow shutter speed shoot of a lion charging something or an elephant coming at you, and get creative blur coming into the process. If you're shooting a waterfall, for example, try and freeze that waterfall by shooting at a high shutter speed, but then go and experiment with slower shutter speeds. You know, if you've frozen all the motion of the waterfall at a thousandth of a second, why not try 125th and see what it looks like, or perhaps a 60th? And then really get crazy and use 4 or 5 or 6 seconds and see what that looks like. If you're shooting a waterfall or something like that, you may need to keep the camera on a tripod so that at least you get some sharp portions to the image. But then again, maybe not. Try it without the tripod. Try and pan with the water coming down and see what that looks like. So you get solid water and blurred surroundings, trees and rocks and that sort of stuff. Could be quite interesting. I think I must give that a go sometime. Number nine. Make images happen. It's not often that a great photograph just arrives out of the middle of nowhere. You've actually got to plan it, you've actually got to think it through, you've actually got to work the subject to make it happen. It's not just a matter of seeing a bird and getting a great photograph. You've got to actually make that picture happen. You've got to look at what's happening in the viewfinder. You've got to decide where you want to position the animal. You've got to decide where it's going to be looking, space to move into, all those sort of things. Think it through, work it, work that subject. Don't just do one picture of it, spend time with it, learn what's happening, and try and create the best image you can. And number 10, have fun. That's the really important one. If you're having fun, the creative juices will flow and you're going to get better images. So don't go out there hating what you're doing. Get the passion going, get the feeling going, and go out there and enjoy what you're doing, and you will get better images. So, hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please give us a thumbs up, and you might like to subscribe to the channel because we have a bunch of videos up there already teaching photography. We've got more coming, so hit the subscribe button and the little reminder bell, and we'll see you on the next one. Thanks for joining us. Cheers.